Been uncertain in his squad, but the rest is likely to be as it has been throughout this tournament. Guimara is a coach who lives every second, every point, and every touch that happens whilst the game's going on.
The defending Olympic champions, Brazil, so they do have just that little bit of extra pressure on them, defending their title, and have made a pretty good fist of things now to get to the semi-finals. And their opponents, Japan, and there's their record, very similar in fact, with the two losses as well. They lost two of their first four games, then account of a Great Britain, and beat their arch Asian rivals China 3-2. So they had both had five setters a couple of days ago. Now, whether that is a factor at all, whether they've fully recovered from the exertion of five sets, remains to be seen. You would think they would be fit enough to handle that, but remember, the five setters came after a week of intensive pool play as well. So, Clayton, fitness could be a factor.
It's part of their game. It could well be a factor, but I do think that they are used to this. They're used to playing five set matches. They're used to playing long, drawn out games. It's how they operate, because they're used to defending. They're used to being able to soak up all the pressure from the other team and then coming back at them, not necessarily with power, but with shots and pace and good deception. And they've got one of the shortest but also one of the greatest setters in world volleyball in the likes of Yoshi Takeshita, number three. She's been voted MVP on numerous occasions at world events, including the World Championships. And you'll also see, as she's not normally going to stay at the right side of court to block during this game, she will move into the middle. She'll try and get away from the hitters and move her middle blockers into a position where they can stop the outside hitters for Brazil.
So the warm-up has been completed. The match about to get underway. The only ritual left is to introduce the starting lineup for the two teams. Japan nearest the camera in their traditional red, and the Brazilians, of course, in their national colour of yellow, which you see in all of their famous and legendary football teams as well. There's part of 15,000 people here again to see this second semi-final. Not only did they win the gold medal 4 years ago, but finished third in 2000 and third in 1996, and finished in the top five at the last five Olympic Games, Brazil. So they do have that consistency across the board. Here are our two officials this evening. On the left, the first referee, Simone Santi from Italy, and Mohamed Nasra Shaban from Egypt, who will be the second referee. So let's have a look at this starting six for Brazil.
Well, no doubt, and Guimarães wants to put out his best team possible, and no surprises. He's going with number one, the captain, Fabiana, through the middle. Number six, Thaisa, also through the middle. And through the outside, it's Jackie who gets the nod. Danny Lins, number three, will be setting. And it's number 16, Faye Garay, who'll be going through the outside. And Sheila Castro, number 13, in the opposite slot. And the ever reliable number 14, Fabienne Oliveira, Fabi, on the back of her shirt as the libero, the defensive specialist.
Fabiana, Litz, Thaisa, Jackie, Sheila, Fabi and Fejere. That's the starting lineup for Brazil.
And out come Japan. A few changes for coach Miyoshi Manabe. Number three, Yoki Takeshita, as expected, starting as the setter. Number five, Erika Arakai, going through the middle. And number 11, Otomo Ai, also going through the middle. But then come the changes. It's number 12, Shinabe Risa, is hitting through the outside. And also Yuko Ibata, number 16. And through the opposite slot is Kimura Seorai, number 18. The libero is Yuko Sano. Interesting couple of changes in terms of having Shinabe in and Ibata in. It's been Yamaguchi and it's been Sakoda, but not for this game.
Interesting. Well, no doubt the coaches have studied meticulously the tapes of every match their opponents have played, and these are the lineups that they've come up with. So all ready for a start. Masayoshi Manabe, coach of the Japanese team, his assistant Abo Kiyoshi, and Jose Gaimaris with the junior Polo, his assistant. And Saori Kimura, who chimed in with 33 points in that quarterfinal a couple of days ago, will start the match. Lots of noise here already, even before the first serve. And nice work from Japan, immediately into their work, but through the middle comes Brazil. I think we'll see a lot of that tonight.
Good start from Taisa, confidence building, swing through the middle. But the warning signs there very clearly from the moment that Brazil attempted their first side out. Japan touching the ball, slowing it down, recycling it and giving Brazil a second opportunity. Brazil are going to be working hard at the net tonight, battering the ball, and it will still keep coming back over.
Japan reply quickly, which is a good thing to do, and on the board as well. Just that first point there just helps settle the nerves, I'm sure.
It's a nice swing from Risa as well, who's not had a great deal of starting volleyball for Japan. This girl has Erika Arakai. She's played pretty much every single game.
Going for the tip. A good reaction there from the Japanese block, but second time they're caught and exposed. The floor unguarded, and Brazil also showing that they, by the look of it, they can match the Japanese with that explosiveness and quick reflex action. Sheila, number 13. 1.87 meter, 6'2". Good thinking there from the Japanese hitter, Ibata.
Well, Japan will mix it up. Cut shots, power, tips, disguise, off the block, around the block, everything they can to make it difficult for Brazil throughout this game.
Keep them guessing. Shinabe. Yeah, good reaction again at the net this time. I think it was Fabiani.
Brazil staying focused, keeping an eye on what's going on. They know the ball's going to come back over. Takashita with a great reaction to try and set it up. And it's Fegere, one-on-one. Good block from her, very disciplined.
Fernandina with the serve. And that quick attack.
Well, even though Brazil have got time, because the ball has to go below the height of the net to get to Takashita and then come back up again, the speed of her setting is what undoes a lot of blocks, and a good example of it with that last play.
Yes, that quick fire attack. Fabiana again with a little touch at the net, proving the undoing for Japan. So these early points coming here from Brazil, not from power, but from precision.
Interestingly, Saori deciding not to go and attack the block. It was a tame hit, and she paid the price for it.
There's the captain of the Brazilian team, Fabiana Claudino. This time Japan prevail off the block.
That's better from Saori. That's what she should have done the last time out. Attacking the block.
Nice work again from Japan. Just putting that ball, just tipping it over the top, and no one from the back row could get to it. So already there's been a lot of variety in this match, and it's only 5 minutes old. Nothing predictable about it from one rally to the next.
I think that's one of the things that makes Japan so great to watch, the way that they mix it up and show all the different skills and variety there is in the game of volleyball. And it's not very often you see them make mistakes from the serving line. They know with their style of play they can ill afford that, because against the bigger teams they're going to come back at them very, very hard on the rebound.
Well picked up by the libero, and a great angle as well.
That was very good work from Shayla. Normally Japan are very good at what we call fronting the spiker. In other words, getting the shoulder opposite to the other shoulder. On that occasion, Risa was too far into court.
No, underneath the net.
Jackie caught wanting in defense. The outside hitter, number eight for Brazil, had moved away from the block, but she was still moving around as the ball was played. Wasn't in a good position with which to play defense, and despite Fabi's best attempts, it wasn't going to come back.
Probably the easiest point that they've picked up tonight, Brazil, through the middle.
So that's the mismatch that Japan are going to have to deal with throughout this match. Thaisa and Fabiana being able to do that. Thaisa on that occasion. The way that Japan will be able to stop that is to serve tough, so Brazil can't go to the middle.
Yes, kept alive, but all that good work rather undone with that rather tame third hit there. It was neither one thing nor the other.
One of the keys to hitting the ball, even if you can hit it slowly, is to make sure you hit through it. Don't stop on contact, and exactly what Fegere did, she stopped on contact. It didn't carry far enough for the drop shot she was looking to make happen.
Slow build up here again. It's the set and the tip, but the Japanese, there won't be too many of those, I'd imagine, that miss. Mind you, the Brazilians as well, showing great agility around the court. Finally, it goes out, and too deep, didn't come off the tip at all of the block. And the Brazilians prevail, and I think we've reached eight. Yes, our first timeout, technical timeout, first of two that we have in each set.
You can just see how quickly that's come about, and how exciting it is that the rallies continue. Japan soaking up all the pressure. They were looking for a block out on that last play, didn't get it. But Brazil know they're going to have to keep hitting. They're going to have to keep working hard, and they know the ball is going to keep coming back. And it's a pointless, a futile exercise for Brazil to tip the ball against Japan, because that's exactly what they're looking for. That was the last point that didn't catch the block, according to anyone. Well, it looked like caught Shayla, actually.
Well, exactly. It looked as if it changed direction. But they don't have the advantage of television replays. It's all done with the naked eye. And I imagine it'll be an issue within the sport, as it has been for most other sports, wrestling with the role of technology and the officiating of a sport. The second hit, there's the third, and a little bonus there maybe for Japan. Virtually it was
it should have been a free ball.
Yeah,
should have been a free ball for Brazil, and the batters come up, put a bit of spin on it, got it between the blockers, and Brazil weren't paying attention.
Seven successful spikes so far for Japan tonight, three of them from Kimura. and two from Abata. And it's all tied up in the first set. Best of five. Both coming off for five setters in their quarterfinal matches 48 hours ago. And there's the kind of hallmark of Brazil. Just some power there with that swing.
It was a nice quick ball in, and then Shayla going wide was able to expose Japan's block. One-on-one, Brazil will definitely profit. Very quick attack for Japan. Ibata was almost in the air as the ball was being set, and that gave hardly any time at all for the Brazil middle block to catch up. The gap exposed, and Japan looking for that every time they can. Inside out.
And a nice Japanese block there. They may not have the height of the Brazilians, but their timing and their reading of the play compensates for that, and they did a good job there. Saori very pleased with the performance of her teammates.
Using the backcourt pipe well and splitting Brazil's block yet again. Japan don't really look to make a lot of blocks for points. They're always looking to slow the ball down so they can go back and recycle it and use their offense.
The Brazilians just starting to flex a little more power and muscle, aren't they, in the last few rallies?
Well, that was pretty good because they've gone over the top of the middle blocker, actually, over at A, instead of going over Takeshita, which is the main option with this rotation, with Takeshita being just over 1.70 meters. She's not the tallest of players.
Nice, straightforward, simple set there from the middle of the front row, and giving the Brazilians a little wee taste of their own medicine there, Japan. And so this pattern has, in a sense, settled down. It's side out after side out, and no one getting away here. One point where it's been for most of the set, and back on equal terms.
Great work from Danny Lin. She'd gone, and the ball was almost an overpass, and Japan were brought into thinking that it was going to be her to play it. So all right, committed, and that left Fabiana with absolutely nobody at all to hit through position two.
Yes, two very fine blocks there from the Brazilian pair as they just crab their way across the net. Wherever the Japanese offense went, they went with them.
Great and footwork from Taisa. She started over to the other side to make the initial block, which was recovered, and then she's got all the way back across 9 meters to make the next one.
So if the pattern unfolds again here, should be side out to Japan, and scores tied up at 12-all. And that's exactly what's happened. So according to your theory, Clayton, it'll all change after the second technical timeout.
That's where it all happens. That's where the mistakes will count double in effect. It's looking like we're going to head into that technical timeout, maybe one or 2 points separating the teams. But it's who can pull away and who can really make the fewest mistakes as we head to the 25 mark.
That's good. Deep into that backcourt.
A small turning point for Japan because they've won a point from serving. They've soaked up the Brazilian pressure, come back, and that's an excellent shot into the corner.
Kimura, chief point scorer so far for Japan with 5 of those 13. Yeah, so they could, to use that tennis expression, just get a little wee mini break here before the next technical timeout, but nope. Back come the Brazilians.
Shayla showing exactly why she's one of the world's best as an opposite hitter.
Lee 13 all. Over the top, but the libero, well, she got to it, but didn't do much with it once she got there.
Well, Fabi's an excellent libero, and in that situation, she'll probably recognise she played the ball with her wrong hand. She played it with her right hand, which makes it difficult. She's trying to play it away to her right. She played it with her left hand. The natural motion of that hand would have brought the ball and her arm back into play. That's a super swing from Shayla.
Yeah, she just cut the ball, didn't she, on the angle, and just sliced the ball away through that two, three-person block. They certainly have the advantage when it comes to power, don't they, the Brazilians? No question about that, and that could be a decisive factor. Height's not a bad thing to have as well when you're trying to put the effective block up. 15 to 14.
Well, for Japan, they ran that too close to Taisa, that middle play. She doesn't have to jump to get her hands above the net. Japan can't hit as high as she can block, and they didn't spread her far enough. They didn't get far enough away from her. So Taisa will give a gift, really.
Yeah, some good, astute thinking there by the Japanese, avoiding the block. And here we are, 15 all. Next point.
We're just getting a little glimpse of his pad, and that's got all the rotations on it and where everybody's hitting from. So much complex information they have on each other.
And there it is. So we've reached our second timeout, this pivotal moment in the set. 16 to 15 in favour of Brazil. Yes, it's far more complex, isn't it, than the game of beach volleyball we have at the beach on a Sunday afternoon on a hot summer's day. You put the net up and see what you can do.
There's six players on court for this one, and you're working out exactly where to serve the ball in order to stop one or maybe two players operating, but that's just in that particular rotation. There's another five rotations and another four attackers, so the variables are huge, and serving is critical, not just to get the rally going, but to put the ball in a place where people, a team will struggle to side out if you're going for a tactical serve. Reduce the middle attack so that you can get your blockers out wide on the slower ball to try and stop them. Or if you've got a really good jump server, to get up there and hit it as hard as you possibly can to stop it coming back altogether.
So just a tiny advantage here for Brazil as we now go into this defining phase of the set. First to 25, remember. And yes, that's ideally one of the functions of the libero here, is to receive the serve, and of course it's the intention of the server to serve the ball away from the libero, but they do have that time once the ball is in play to get across. Didn't that time, and there we are. Maybe they should have lifting.
Yeah, carry called against Takeshita. She was given a really difficult ball in. I was a little bit too generous to her when I said she was just over 1m70. She's 1m59, and she's given it her all to get something on it, but it stayed in her hand for too long. She can operate on a fast, flat ball into her, which is, helps them to speed their play up. She doesn't need a ball like she just got.
Again, trying to avoid the block, which the Japanese did. And a repeat deja vu. And this time, the Brazilians. Here comes the assault. The Japanese come back. Oh, this is a great rally. And this time, magnificent stuff here from the Japanese, but the block prevails. Oh, what a rally. It's a pity that both teams can't get a point for that. They deserve it.
Brilliant defense from Taisa, the big middle blocker. No libero on court for Brazil in that rally. And Taisa held her ground and made a magnificent dig cross court, which set up Brazil then to get the better of that rally in the ball. A little too tight from Japan at the net, and Brazil were all over it. So Manabe spotting the trouble here, called timeout straight away because they're now suddenly 3 points down. It's all off the back of that one bad pass, and then they can't side out. Brilliant work from Jackie, but Tyson, number six, made an exceptional dig as well. You'd expect the libero for Japan to keep making the digs. Yuko Sano, she's brilliant at it, but the blocking in the end was the difference.
Well, just as well we didn't show you the full replay from the word go. Start of that rally would probably still be here at midnight. It seemed to go on forever. And now, for the first time in the set, one team with a little three-point break on the other. In favour of the Brazilians, but it's been quickly reduced by that unforced serving error to two. And still the noise from the fans from that rally reverberating around Earl's Court here. Too much power from Shayla.
She's on form tonight, is Shayla, in this match. She's playing exceptionally well. And proving that, give her the ball, she'll put it away.
Great work by the libero. This is just amazing. The defense again of the Japanese here. But it's the block. There's, in the end, there's no way through that block, is there? Or around it for the Japanese. And this is where the Brazilians are prevailing at the moment.
It's just absolutely amazing to watch. As predicted, Japan soaking up everything Brazil have got. But when it come down to it, it's Brazil's defence, which is now proving to get the better of Japan's offence at the net.
1.94 metres. Fabiana, their captain, number one. And up she went. Because the other kind of subtle skill, which is not always visually evident, is it, in blocking, is the anticipation that the blockers have to bring, the ability to read the play going on the other side of the net, to know where they have to be when the spike comes.
Lots of pressure on them from a good ball in transition, in recycled play, when it breaks down slightly and there's not so many people moving, that makes it a little bit easier. And those last 2 points that they've won from block, the ball could only go wide, and that meant the middle blockers were able to join up with Danny Lins on the outside and close the gaps. And when you've got Fabiana there and Taisa, who can reach right across the net, then Japan have found themselves in trouble.
Yeah, well, they've got the side out, which they need, just to reduce that gap by 3 points, or 2 3-points. Substitution made. On comes Kano, by the look of it, number eight.
It's a blocking substitution, and also bringing in the backup setter as well. So Nakamichi, number two, is the backup setter for Japan, and she's in across the back row.
Here comes Fabiana again, and beautifully disguised. She came around and then just deep out that right arm swing, and valuable point. There she is. You would think for all money it's going to be the big swing, but no. Three of the Japanese players went fishing for it, but that was the one that got away. 21-17. Should not lose the set from here, Brazil. Easily picked up on the back row, and it looks too big. Must have come off a Japanese hand. Japanese hand, and Brazil get the point.
High and wide for Jackie, and she attacks the block.
Yeah, the left hand there of the blocker right on the sideline. So 5 points the difference, 3 points required for Brazil. A great save by the libero. Yes, great thinking by their setter there. Saw the little gap and just tipped it over. That's always a sign of quick thinking, astute setter, being able to read the game well. And vital little point at this point there.
Magnificent dig from Yuko Sano. But Japan just backing off and not paying attention, and that lapse in concentration cost them, because the ball was really tight to the net. Danny Lins wasn't a great deal of things she could have done with the ball. because of where it was, but Japan were expecting more of her than she actually delivered. It's a good serving run from Fegere.
Little bonus point there as well at the net for Brazil at Japan's expense.
Well, Jackie held her ground and let the slide behind from Japan come to where she was standing.
So yes, the first set point of the match. Desperate here for Japan, but eventually they just give free ball here, and through the middle comes Brazil, but Japan fighting tooth and nail here. They you wouldn't think they're really in the set at the moment at 24-18, but they haven't given up.
They will not give up on anything. It's a bit like a live fish on a chopping board. They will keep on going till the very end, and just when Brazil think they've got it done, Japan will still keep coming back at them.
There it is. The first set wrapped up, fittingly enough, by their captain, Fabiana, who has been one of the best players on the court in this first set. And she is the tall figure at the back there, number one. The tallest member of their team at 6 feet four, meter 94. And Brazil indicating to the United States, I imagine, as well as the Japanese, that they're going to be very hard to take the gold medal off. They are the defending champions, and suggesting they are in very good form to go back to back. But a long way to go in this semi-final. And there are the stats from that first set: 16 out of 40 for Japan, 14 out of 34. Look at the blocks: 8 versus 0.
So no kill blocks for Japan, but what they did make was lots of continuation blocks, which enabled them to get the ball back in and go after Brazil. But that is a big, big blocking stat for Brazil, to make that many blocks for points against Japan. That's not easy to do.
Yes, there is this a height difference between the two teams. Brazil have at least half of their squad 6 feet or taller. In Japan, their tallest player is a meter 86, which is 6 feet one. Their captain, Araki. The battle at the net, won fairly conclusively in that set by Brazil, and delight on the faces of their fans as well as their players. He's got a good vertical leap, that youngster.
Star of the future.
A blocker in the making. Kimura, the top point scorer for Japan in that first set with 6, and three other players all contributing 3 points. And Brazil, their top point scorers, Fabiana, their captain, with 6, and Sheila also with 6. And there's 8 kill blocks also. Essentially, the difference between the two teams, 25-18, 7 points between them, 8 kill blocks from Brazil. Certainly helped set up that first set. Pensive look on the faces of some of the Japanese supporters. I think they realise that their girls are in for a tough night at the mill. That's what the Japanese have to do to the Brazilians in this second set, which is about to get underway. And a long ball there with the free ball, and not able to tidy it up under the net there, the Brazilians. And so Japan do get the first point in the second set. Looking to lead that Japanese assault in the first set. So Audi with the seven spikes. Nearly kept it alive, but a valiant attempt.
Interesting play in that rally was the fact that despite this amazing effort again from the libero, Yuko Sano, was the fact that the setter played the ball but played it specifically to the libero in that rally for her then to set up the ball for an attack. A lot of teams do that now.
Yes. Beautifully positioned.
Well, that's good work from Fagere, brought right inside the court as well, having to hit from pretty much the middle of court where Taisa would normally operate. And unfortunately, the libero for Japan getting stuck behind the block and couldn't see the ball.
Settling into the pattern we saw in the first set. Side out after side out. Off the block, but out to court. 3-2 to Brazil. Daisy. Two successful spikes in the first set. Wow, smart, quick thinking again at the net there for Brazil. The ball was there. Can't put your hand over into the opponent's court, but go high. Yes, it was clearly over the net, so that was a fair game there for Fabiana.
Well, it's the next best thing from an ace is to generate an overpass that your front court attackers can put away. Well, this is worrying now for Brazil, for Japan. Brazil 3 points up already. Unforced error.
Well, the idea was right, I guess. The cut spike, but didn't get the timing exactly right, and so 3 points here. Thought we might have had a timeout there from Japan, but mightn't be far away. What's the call? Off that block and out, so 6-2. I'm sure there'll be a timeout now, won't there?
Indeed. You can't let it continue.
The technical timeout is only 2 points away, but Japanese coach needs to speak to them now.
He'd rather not go in 8-2 down. He'd rather go in 8-6 up.
Or at least 8-4 or something, but... Yes, I guess we can't underestimate just the value of the team coming off the court after having lost a few points, just having 30 seconds out, just high-fiving each other, exchanging a few words, and then just resetting their mind for the task in hand. So now the question is whether Brazil can regain that momentum. Bit of a joust at the net, and it goes the way of Japan, so the timeout probably worked.
Well, that's very good work from Otomo Ai. She's got a height mismatch against Fabiana, but she waited and then pushed, and it was the last push that did it.
Still trying to find that elusive kill block, the Japanese. Once more through the middle come the Japanese, but no one prepared to give this rally up. But eventually, Fabiana unable to control the ball, and the Japanese persevere. Much needed point two, they were trailing 3-6.
Another spectacular rally, everybody involved, everybody getting in on the action. Wonderful work from Fegere to keep that one in play. And then the slide behind and the tip, eventually good enough.
Yes, so Fabiana had to turn and chase it and never really caught up with it.
That's a brilliant angle from Shayla.
Mm.
I don't think she's missed a spike at the moment in this game.
Six to her credit so far. That's okay, just cleared the top of the net.
Well, it's gone against Brazil here. It's a net touch.
They're protesting it.
But it's really difficult, this situation, because the ball was travelling into the net. Now, if the ball hits the net and hits the player, then that's fine. And they've not touched the net. The ball's been played down into the net, and the ball has made the net move. So that's why they feel hard done by, and they have been hard done by.
Yeah, it should have been probably the technical timeout there at 8-4. So a little bit of luck there for the Japanese, but we will have that timeout now. The eighth point. And, Brazil leading by three early in the second set after taking the first 25-18.
It's a very different Brazil to the one that we've witnessed so far in this tournament. And the thing that they've picked up on, the thing that they're really getting to work well, is their blocking at the moment. And they're shutting down Japan. They've realised just how much of a threat Japan are once they've recycled the ball. And they're working extremely hard to be disciplined in the block and not make gaps. And it's paying dividends for them at the moment.
And that also is the area where the Japanese are struggling, isn't it? They can't affect any of those blocks. As you say, they're recycling the blocks, but not getting the points with them from the kills.
Normally Japan will keep wearing you down, and either the team that keeps getting dug and having the ball back to them makes an unforced error because they're getting a little bit frustrated, or they give the ball back to Japan, who eventually go off their block and out. But Brazil have stayed very disciplined in both departments and have played some exceptional volleyball.
Fegere restarting proceedings with the serve that's just a little wee bit overcooked. So Japan trying to drag themselves back to a point of parity here with the Brazilians. Tomo, pretty good fist of things so far. Five spikes from six attempts, five successful ones. What's the call there? Nope, over the top of the block and out. Another point to Japan.
Jackie trying to influence the referee by saying it had touched the block. Paola with the headband yet to get on court. She was a starter at the beginning of this tournament, but she's had her place taken from her by Fegere, who, when she's come on court, has done the business. So much so, Guimarães now has effectively made her the number one outside hitter along with Jackie. And Jackie showing why she's good for her place on court. Best place to go, straight over the top of Takeshita. She's miles above it. Takeshita just getting her hands over there, and not as high as Erika Arakai.
Good illustration there of why so many of these players have their fingers taped. Yes, retrieved nicely by that back row player for Brazil. The big spike and the block, but it's out of court from the Brazilian block. And Japan pulling their way back into this match.
Well, the substitute, Sayori Sakoda, who came on at the start of the set, now having an impact.
Brazilians this time recycling it from the block, and Japan unable to really control that block at all. It goes out. Up goes Jacques, and off the block and out. Jacques with 6 points so far from the match. No, too big.
Jackie was going for the gap in the block, trying to get it cross court. Slightly off balance, slightly leaning away to her left as she played it. Just over rotating slightly. Well, it's standard stuff for Brazil. A quick, use Thais's height, use Fabiana's height, and Japan just don't have a match for it. But that's all important as well. Danny Lin's putting that ball into that space for Thais to hit. And the setters, they keep an eye on the blockers next to them with their peripheral vision. They know whereabouts they are and where they need to put the ball for the attackers then to go into. But once again, the Brazilian block is spot on.
These invaluable points they're getting from their blocks. Here's another one. And all of a sudden they've just split this set open a little here at 12-9. Wow, great work there from the libero. Through the middle, yes, works for Brazil, and it's working for Japan.
Well, Fabi with an excellent dig at the initial part of that rally, but second time around, she holds her position, but then she moves, has to shift back. If she'd have stayed where she was, she'd have made the dig. And that's a common error you see in volleyball, players fighting to get into a position instead of just staying where they are and playing from wherever they happen to be. You don't fight for position, you fight to keep the ball off the floor. Not much you could do about that one, though.
Not with that sort of power. And so Japan matching the Brazilians for spikes. But it's at the net that's the blocking of the Brazilians, which has been the difference between the two teams. 13-10. Getting close to that second technical timeout at 16. A couple of important moments here for Japan, but there's one that's gone against them. 14-10.
Well, the blocking is sublime at the moment from Brazil. They're so disciplined. They're not reaching outside their body line. They're not chasing the ball. They're getting set early and then going straight across the net.
Yes. That was a bit of a free ball on the end there for Japan, as they just popped over the net at a very gentle pace, and the blockers were away on leave, and easy point there for Japan, which they need it to 14-11. And it's out.
What a worrying moment for Brazil as it went down that line, but Jackie had it covered.
Little Fabi there just at 1.66 alongside of a captain at 1.94, so 30 centimeters basically between them. It's not just a game for tall people. Good block, but good reception there from Japan. So trying something different, but gee, That was almost a gift there in the end. Just popping the ball over, basically a free ball, and away it went, crashing into the floor from the big swing. And so there we are, 16 to 11, and Brazil very much in the box seat here.
Well, Danny Lins has now got 100% hitting stats. The setter doesn't normally get a swing. That's why it was, she was so delighted with the fact she'd been given the ball up for a free put away. But it's all going right for Brazil at the moment. They can't seem to do anything wrong at all. And if there is a slight blip, if the serve goes in the net or a spike goes long, they come straight back with the side out. And they're looking all the time like they're going to get another point. They're going to get another point. And the pressure really is on Japan at the moment.
And their attack just looks more fluent, doesn't it, and focused the further the match goes.
Well, they've established Taisa and Fabiana in the middle, so Japan's middle blockers are having to hold and wait, which makes the job a little bit easier then for the outside hitters. And at the moment, the good ball in, they are forcing the middle, so Brazil are using Taisa and Fabiana every opportunity. Taisa in front and Fabiana on the slide behind, and Japan can't deal with it.
And the second set slipping away here for the Japanese. It's 17 to 11.
Well, they think there was a net touch in the block. It's not been given. But super discipline as well from Fabiana, because Takeshita went up. The ball was so close to the net. She could quite easily have gone up and tried to make a block, or believing that Takeshita was going to play it over. She didn't. She waited. She followed the ball out wide. Japan then had two blockers to contend with, and in trying to miss the block, has missed the court. So Fabiana, excellent piece of work from her to help generate a point for her team.
Yes, when you look at the way Brazil are playing tonight, it's hard to believe that they lost two of their pool matches, one of them to Korea and the other to the USA. Admittingly, those two teams made it through to the quarterfinal. But two losses and three wins. And an important 3-2 win over Russia in the quarterfinals. There probably was an indication of the fact that they were starting to play some of their best volleyball with that win over that formidable Russian side a couple of days ago. Wow, how many times have they used that little attack in the second set, and it's worked every time.
Well, Danny Lins was struggling at the net. She's had to go up with one hand, and everybody thought she was going to go over. So a lack of discipline from Japan, which allowed Fabiana to have a swing with no block in front of her. Cracks are starting to appear now in the Japanese game.
Really on the back foot, aren't they? The Japanese at the moment can't get their attack working because they're on the back foot. And appeal there from the Japanese, but shake of the head from the first referee. 19 to 12, running away with the second set.
Fantastic dig set from Takeshita from one corner of the court over to the other to set the ball up for Sayori Kimura. Unfortunately for her, it didn't find the block on its way out, and Brazil take the point.
Easily picked up there by Fabi. And the foot is on the pedal now for the Brazilians. They are motoring here through this second set.
Again, the tactic used, just going over the top of Takeshita and scoring the point.
Quite what Masayoshi Manabe does at the end of this second set, which is coming quickly. I don't know, but he's got a whole sack full of problems. Fabi, she's doing some fantastic work there, isn't she? The balls that she's picking up, the Libero, there she is, little Fabiani, 5 feet five, 166 centimetres. And in that restricted role, Libero, I guess, loosely translated means free, but the curious things about the Libero is that they are restricted on a lot of things they do. They're basically a backcourt defensive player designed to be able to receive the ball, get down to the ground quickly because of their low centre of gravity. And she is in the navy blue strip.
Double touch cord against Japan. Brazil are playing Japan at their own game at the moment. They've turned it around. So the ball not deemed to have touched the block, and so that was the second touch, hence the signal for two touches by the referee, although really he should have signaled four because it was their fourth touch. Certainly wasn't a double touch in the set by Takeshita. But Brazil are playing Japan's game here. They're recycling the ball and then they're coming back and taking on Japan's block. And at the moment, Japan are restricted to the odd side out.
And there was one of them. But this won't terribly upset the Brazilians now as they wait to receive the serve. Coming from Kano. And she's on for Tomo. Ah, that's better from the Japanese. Really good, powerful block there.
It's an interesting combination. Danny Lins decided to bring Jackie into court, and that meant that Erika Arakai never had anywhere to go. She just waited for Jackie to come into her.
And that, I think, yes, there it is. The very first block, kill block anyway. A block which the Japanese were able to turn into a point from 21 attempts, but back in business, the Brazilians at 23 to 14 with Fabiana.
But again, it's that slide behind from Fabiana.
Still their top point scorer with 9, just ahead of Shayla with 8, Jackie with 8, and 7 opposition errors have contributed to their 48 points so far in the match.
A double substitution by Brazil. The setter has gone into the back row, Fernandinha, and Tandara has come on at the net for some height and blocking. And it's all been immediately reversed.
Here comes the new setter. So we arrive at set point in this second set for Brazil. They will serve for the set. And a very strong grip on this semi-final as well if they win this rally. There's their captain, Fabiana, must be pretty pleased with the way her team has played so far. Japanese. A real sting in that spike, easily picked up. And there goes Fabiana. The Japanese fighting hard to keep it alive, but it's that old story, the block. Almost a dismissive note about that block from the Brazilians as they just flicked it away onto the floor on the Japanese side of the court, and that seals the second set for Brazil, 25 to 15, and just 25 minutes as well. So 50 minutes of volleyball, and Brazil very much in the box seat here, one set away from a place in the final. And look at those spikes, 18 from 31 attempts, just the 3 blocks. Digs pretty even, and a couple of aces, a couple of service errors, but no aces from either side. And in the end, pretty easy for the Brazilians, 25 to 15.
That's the block from Taiser up across the net, not waving her arms around, not reaching outside of her body line. Grimaris is delighted. He's a good tactician. He scouted Japan extremely well, and we've seen that with the way that they have played their volleyball and what they've been interested in at the net, Brazil, and how they've gone out and blocked and how they've taken on Japan as we have a look at the highlights from the set. And I think despite Taiza's couple of serving errors, she's been exceptional both in blocking, in her A-quick attacking, and also in defence. She's made a couple of crucial pickups that have contributed to the team when Fabi's been off court, the libero. But Brazil will not switch off for a second here. They can't afford to, because Japan, if they get a chance, they will take it. I don't think Japan have got anything more in the tank. There's nothing they can do, nothing they can change in the way that they're playing. It's whether or not Brazil can keep the level up that they've shown over the last two sets.
Yes, the level of intensity which the Brazilians brought to the game right from the start. And they, well, it is the semi-final at the Olympic Games. There shouldn't be an issue here in motivation or focus. And it's Gomardus's job, I guess, to keep his players focused on the job at hand. But you have to think, when you've got two sets in the bank, you don't want to get ahead of yourselves, but Brazil shouldn't lose from here. But as we've said before, we've seen it here at the Olympic Games in London in 2012, sides coming back from two sets down.
Well, no changes for Brazil. I'm not surprised. He's going to keep his strongest team out, doesn't want to change the rhythm, not going to give the bench a run out because they're two sets up. He wants to win this 3-0, get off court and get ready for the final.
Kimura, who's a leading scorer for the Japanese team, the only player to get into double figures so far with 10 points.
A brilliant start for Brazil. Three blockers in, Fakere and Thaisa lining up and shutting out Japan.
It's almost like a spear through the heart of the Japanese, isn't it, when that ball comes back from the block. And they must just wonder, how on earth can we get round this? This Thaisa, 5 from 6, very good all-round game. I don't know whether they'll get that. Well, there's the second one, and let's have a look now.
Well, they're not giving up on anything. It's only the second point of the set and they were all out as if it was match point. And that shows the intensity that Brazil have at the moment. Sheila, great effort, good touch. Everyone in close. In fact, if they'd have talked to her and just said, get a hand on it, they'd have been able to recycle it. She put too much on it.
The captain of the Japanese team with the serve. Wrecking her brain, wondering exactly what she can do here to turn the fortunes of her team around, but not sure whether there's much actually.
That was as good as a free swing for Fegere. And that's why she's in ahead of Paola. She hits harder, she jumps higher, and she's a better blocker.
Well, imagine what the Japanese want to do here, Clayton, is just to stay with the Brazilians till somewhere around that second technical timeout and then maybe step up the assault or their attack.
They did it in the first set, but then were unable to capitalize. They were completely taken apart in the second, and they will need to do something if they can in the third.
There's a nice set. Here comes the big spike through the middle, but, well, they get the point. As if the Japanese back row player had got underneath it, but the arms to the right of the body, and that's where the ball went. Well, they were perfect in the previous set, even though they were soundly beaten. They did not have a false serve to their name. Faulty serve, but one early in this third set. And this brings the Brazilian captain to the service line.
Taisa is just really on fire at the moment.
She just has the measure, doesn't she, of that Japanese attack at the moment.
She has a look.
There's the jump now. She waited, timed it to perfection.
It was a good block as well, because she didn't just stand there and put one hand out. She actually moved her body and took away the angle with both arms.
They don't need spikers, do they, Brazil at the moment? The blockers are leading the way, spearheading this charge into the final by 6-3.
It's the best blocking performance I've seen from Brazil in a long, long time. And now Japan have called the timeout.
Well, they've registered 14 kills so far with their blocking, which is quite remarkable. That would represent a pretty good haul from five sets, wouldn't it? 14. And here we are, barely into the third set, and it's just proving too difficult for Japan. They're just getting foiled time and time again.
Well, the play we were expecting, where they were soaking up the Brazilian offense and coming back with the shots around, through and off the block, just haven't happened. Brazil have been so disciplined in that department that anything that's gone into the block has gone down pretty much for a point for them, or Brazil have been able to recycle it.
You'd imagine the American team somewhere in the city, if not in the stadium, are watching this. And if they do meet Brazil in the final, must be wondering how they will get round this powerful defensive unit of the Brazilians. The Americans do bring a bit more height, of course, to the game, which will be a key factor.
There'll also be more time pressure on Brazil's block as well. They won't have as much time as they're currently getting because of the difference in height between setters, between Japan and the USA. Of course, that's if Brazil do go on to take this set. There's nothing to suggest they won't, the way that they're playing.
The Japanese team fired by desperation at the moment. Magnificent sight, isn't it? Up goes Shaler again, and that big swing, and just powers the ball into the back row.
This is given lots of line to work with. Japan not forcing her to go cross court.
Well, they've rappelled to the Japanese. Let's have a look now. Over the top. And just wearing them down mentally as well. They come up with the big spikes, the Japanese, and they get foiled. And their concentration maybe just disappears for a moment. And bang, the Brazilians strike with a little dink. That really must be like a, as I said, like a spear through the heart of these Japanese players. Everything they try, they get thwarted.
Well, the tip from Shaler wasn't helped by the fact that as the libero's Yuko Sano came into play, it sliding in, Erika Arakai put out a hand and took it away from her. We've seen that in other matches, middle blockers going up, the ball getting tipped past them, instead of turning around and watching to see what's going on, making desperate attempts to play a ball, and in so doing taking it away from their teammates. This was the rally, the beginning of it, and as the ball is played up, and then eventually when Brazil get to have a swing, good work from Fabi, and then Danny Lin's going down low to give some space. Watch Erica Arica, she just gets a little nick on it, and if anything just took it away slightly from the libero. But it's so super play, very disciplined, focused play from Brazil, the best I've seen them.
Leans their setup. And Fabi, who said a fabulous game, actually.
Well, it's a blocking masterclass from Brazil right now. And I've no doubt that the FIVB will be looking at this video and making some a technical video from this in the way to set up your block and put pressure on another team.
This time it works for the Japanese off the block. That's been a pretty rare sight, though.
Well, it's a substitute. Huri Inoue off the block and out, going on the slide behind. It's the first time Jackie's had to deal with that.
Takeshita comes into the game. The whistle had gone. Must have been an infringement there.
It's a net touch against Brazil, just overreaching and trying too hard to put the ball down. They're so full of confidence.
Yes, the
Sheila just touching the top of the net. Yes. And the net touch is quite specific. You can touch the bottom of the net and make an incidental touch, and that's fine. Oh, that's brilliant. But if you touch the top of the net and the plane moves, so it comes down, then it's an infringement. Well, Thais has done that all match long so far, and no one has been able to stop her.
Too big. No touch on it from the Brazilian block either, so the gap now 4 points, and it will have a timeout, a Japanese timeout, I'm sure. Not quite sure what he can pull out of the hat here, the Japanese coach. And here we are already using up his second timeout, and we're technically, possibly, not even at the halfway stage of the set, potentially. And he'll have the technical timeout.
It's the Brazilian block has put so much pressure on Japan that the players are going up now, and they're genuinely worried about what's in front of them. Mm. And those hitting errors from Kimura are a direct result of that, where she's thinking the block's there, I've got to avoid it, and she's just making mistakes as a result, instead of being aggressive like they were at the beginning of the first set and taking the block on, looking for the gaps, looking for the wipe-offs. They've changed the way that they are approaching the Brazilian block.
Now trying something a little different, and it worked. With the cut, spike, try to avoid. And Fabi, a few things to say to her frontline players. Not the sort of thing the Japanese need right at this moment when they're trailing 8-11. Daiza.
He's just waiting, trying to work out what Guimarães wants and where he wants her to serve.
Of all the dominance that Brazil are exerting here, Japan are not that far behind on the score sheet in this set, 12-9. And that's it. Easily turned around. Will they go through the middle? No. off the block and out. So Japan are certainly not playing, are they, Clayton, like a team that's down and out and just waiting for the countdown here.
They will never, ever give up. They will always keep fighting. They'll always keep playing.
And you look at the commitment in this rally here to, from those Japanese players, you would have thought that this was a set point in the fifth set.
I've never seen a Japan team come off the court and having not given it their all every single time they play.
Yes, well, it's a very much part of their culture, isn't it? Have to be a bit of a free ball here. No, even there from the 3 metre line. They're still on for the spike. This body's all over the floor and the tip. What's the call? It's off the block and out.
Well, that's more like the Japan we saw in the first set. Henry Maris looks a little anxious. He'll just try and keep his team ticking over here.
Yeah, we're trying to wear the Brazilians down, I guess, with these long, protracted rallies. And that's where they come into their own, these Japanese players. They love to run, dive, slide, pancake, anything at all they can do to keep the ball alive and hang in there and try and take the rally that way. 13-10. Here they are through the middle, but the Japanese picking that up. Yes, try to just dink it over the top and came off the Brazilian blocker's hands. Might have been Fabiani and out.
Superb covering by Japan, not giving it up. And then it's a lovely play. Just looking to go off the block and out, although to be fair, that actually looked as if I played it last.
Yeah.
But she's got away with it.
Looked as if the block was going to work there for Japan, but just didn't get the angle right with the hand, and out it went, 14-11. Libero for Japan, waiting for the serve.
Great work from Jackie. Came in, opened up the cross court angle. Everything looked like she was going to go cross court. Japan thought she was going to go there. She's let the ball drift and then hammered it to the line. Classic swing hitting. And Brazil still in the driving seat. They're playing some great volleyball. That passage of play Japan have had, it seems to me that Brazil now have just got a handle on it, and they're going to stop Brazil playing, or Japan playing.
Figueroa with the serve. Another valuable point. We have reached the second compulsory timeout, the technical timeout. 16-11.
Japan had a little fight back in that, in between the race from 8 to 16. A few points, got the crowd going, got themselves excited, and Brazil have just shut them down again. Two quick points, and way back in the driving seat. Guimarães will be all smiles and happy, and his team certainly all smiles, but very focused.
The only thing I would say about the Brazilians there, Clayton, they don't look to be moving with quite the same dynamic agility as the Japanese do, and I just wonder whether the sheer intensity of these 2.5 sets has just slowed them down a bit.
I think what they're doing is the fact that they're able to stop Japan from operating has been the big difference. And Japan are having to work so hard. Natural part of Japan's game is to have lots of movement off of the pass around the setter. Brazil, not so much. They keep it pretty, let's go wide and one through the middle. And it's two very different styles of play. But at the moment, Brazil very much in control, and they look very much like they're the team who are going to go and probably get further away in this set.
Brazilian fans. Well, it's been a while since they won the Football World Cup, but they may well be celebrating a gold medal It's a few days away yet, but they're certainly in the mood there tonight, appreciating this wonderful display by Brazil. Now remember, the Japanese coach has used his two timeouts. We've had the last technical timeout, so they're on their own here.
The only thing they'll be able to do now to slow play down is call a substitution, and may even call a timeout, purposefully knowing he hasn't got one, just so he gets a yellow card, and which will delay proceedings anyway, because they have to fill in the score sheet. I've seen that happen before.
Off the block and out. You remember the Brazilian side and the Japanese team, for that matter, did play five sets in their quarterfinal matches against Korea and Russia, respectively. But just the way the Japanese team is just charging after every ball, they clearly have come to London here superbly fit and with the stamina to play five sets as often as they are required. There we are. The serve, the dipping, floating serve, proving elusive there for the Japanese as the libero just kind of moved her arms across the ball. And 18 to 12. Again, you look at those Brazilian players, they're looking fairly static on the court there compared to the Japanese. And
well, they were flooding the cross-court area, three players trying to stop Sora Kimura, and in the end it was just the fact it was a good spike, and the fact that it was Fabiana on court and not Fabi, the libero, was the difference.
Ah, the mark of a smart setter, right? She saw it.
Nice play from Danny Lins. Yeah. Japan were expecting a set to have been made, and they weren't focused on each of the individual touches in the course of that rally.
Now she gets to serve. Bit of their own medicine back from the Japanese, 19 to 14.
Brazil not too happy with that. They felt the ball was carried. They stayed in the attacker's hand too long, which is why they were complaining. Well, it did look as if it had gone wide for a second.
Didn't
and that's
it, yeah.
It's the first time Thaïs has actually gone across her body down to position one. She spent the entire match hammering the ball down to position five. But she gets away with it.
So 5 points away from winning this semi-final, Brazil, and you think they should be able to just side out from here with a six-point lead. They'll try and blast their way, I imagine, to victory, and the Japanese prevailing in that rally, 20 to 15. So now this is where Brazil will want to focus on these side outs that we talk about here. If they can just win a few of these in the next few minutes, the match will be theirs. And there we are. There's one of them. Side out Brazil, 21-15.
Thaïs are definitely stronger when she comes around the setter and hits the way she's facing. She's not that comfortable hitting across her body. And she's been unstoppable tonight throughout the match in that middle slot with every swing she's had. No unforced errors.
Yes, nicely recovered initially from the Brazilians, but couldn't keep it in. Is it so? You look at the spread of the points tonight for Brazil. Five players have scored 10 points or more, but no one has scored more than 12. So it was a very even spread. Fabiani, Jackie, Shayla, and Fegere. And there's another one, just doing it with subtlety and deft touches at the moment. Brazil, 22-16. Yes, he knows the writing is on the wall. That's not, of course, the end of the road here for Japan. If they are to lose here, they will be back here competing for a medal. Of course, if this game pans out the way it looks it is, as if it's going to, it'll be Japan and Korea for the bronze medal, and Brazil and the United States, the Americas, an all-American final and an all-Asian final for the bronze medal. Where's Europe?
It just hasn't been their tournament in the women's event. It has in the men's.
Off the block and out.
One last chance now for Japan. Kano in with some height at the net. And they're going to try again to get this back if they can. But Brazil just two side outs away from making it to another final.
We have come to match point for Brazil. The defending champions stand on the cusp of making another Olympic final here, 24-17. Probably the most dominant performance we've seen from any team here in the women's draw at these Olympic Games. Might have lost a couple of matches in their pool play, but gee, they were a different team in the knockout phase. And the Japanese probably just going a little through the motions, and they win the point, 24-18. Yes, the look on the face of the Japanese supporters says it all. Compare that with the composed look on the face of the Brazilian captain there, Fabiana. Gamaras doesn't want them easing off here. Here's their chance. And there it is. Finished fittingly in a domineering style with a huge swing and a wonderful spike. And everyone celebrating here, as the Brazilians do, famous for their celebrations. I haven't won the gold medal yet, girls, but it'll be a great sight if they do on the basis of this.
Well, they've guaranteed themselves a medal. They've achieved. They've come out, their game plan has been perfect. But not only that, they've executed it marvellously. They shut Japan down at the net. They soaked up everything Japan had to throw at them. It's been a totally dominant performance from Brazil. And they've laid a marker for the USA ahead of the final.
They know how much this means to folk back home, how they'd love to go to the next Olympic Games in their own country as the defending champions, looking for a three-peat. But that's all in the future. They've got a few issues here they've got to resolve in London before they can think about that. But well, you think they're almost identical twins, wouldn't you, those girls there? Yes, it's really more girls' court than earls' court tonight, isn't it, Clayton, with this fun and this party that's raging down there amongst the Brazilians.
Well, the fans will be partying long into the night. No such joy for Brazil. They'll be back and recuperating and using the next day to prepare for the final. And I think what we're going to see is a gold medal match with two even teams. It should be spectacular. And again, in the bronze medal match, two even teams, Korea versus Japan. That's going to be spectacular. The final is going to be spectacular as well. I can't wait.
Yes, the two matches will square off physically, won't they? The Japanese and the Koreans, no real height advantage to either side there. And this towering physical presence of the Brazilians, more than matched by the height and muscular approach of the Americans as well. So it could be a blocking war. And some wonderful spikers and attackers there as well. So the ingredients for, well, it will be a repeat of what we had 4 years ago in Beijing, where the Brazilians prevailed over the Americans. And I imagine Herb McCutcheon, the American coach, as we speak, is making lots of notes on what he's seen tonight. And their battle plan will start to be written from about now in preparation for this final. There it is. Brazil, far too good. They took 76 minutes to put Japan away earlier in this day. In the other semi-final, it took the Americans 75 minutes to put Korea away. And this is how it finished. The Japanese players, and I think the end, just stood around in awe and probably were paying some respect there to the Brazilians for the sheer domination that they brought to this game. And there in the background, the Japanese players, a little bewildered, disappointed, but they will be playing for a medal. They do have the chance to go back to Japan with a medal from the Olympic Games. And Fabi, who had a wonderful game,
it's Danny Lins and Jackie, and it's quite a popular tradition for them to say hi to the families and friends back home. Well, the tale of the set, and as far as it goes, I mean, just blocks, none again for Japan, and even their continuation blocks didn't work for them in that third set. They were totally outplayed.
Now look at the blocks here. They make interesting look, 14-1, and that was the difference.
A fabulous game of volleyball and two fabulous games. I think the only difference going into this, as we see that Brazil play the United States for the gold medal match, the only difference between this game coming up and the game back in 2008 was that in 2008 Brazil were the favourites. Here, the United States are the favourites. That's the only difference. But
after tonight's display, the favouritism, I think, Clayton, there won't be much between it, will it? I mean, that's probably the best performance we've seen from any women's team here this week, isn't it?
Absolutely, and I think Brazil will thrive on that, knowing that, as far as the books are concerned, they're going in as underdogs, but they will be full of confidence going into this as we have a look at the highlights from what's been a stunning game of volleyball.
So Brazil continue their remorseless march into the final, where they will meet the United States. They'll do battle for the gold medal in the volleyball here at Earls Court.